Welcome back to another episode of WJAG-TV.
I'm Aaliyah Mal.
And I'm Olivia Duber.
And this is WJAG-TV with your weekly school news. Pagan Pride Day was held a few weeks ago downtown. I asked the Gunterman attendant to gain more insight on the Athens pagan community and what it's about.
Pagan Pride is an annual festival held in downtown Athens to recognize and celebrate the pagan community.
Paganism, in my mind, is anyone who celebrates the ancient traditions which involve following the cycles of the moon and the cycles of the seasons.
I would describe it for me as a long spiritual path. It's more in tune with nature, earth, the elements, and then taking a lot of different gods and goddesses into consideration, whatever resonates with you.
Personally, paganism to me is the freedom to do what I want, making sure that I respect everyone and everything that's around me.
Paganism is always personal, almost always, because it's not one thing, it's many different things, and different things to different people. That there's a reverence for nature, that you celebrate the feminine in divinity, likely to have polytheistic or at least dual two gods.
I think of it more as any spirituality or belief or whatnot that is earth and or energy based.
In some ways it differs a lot because it's more earth-centered and more naturally in tune with the elements, but it's also similar in that you'll have people who are rigid practitioners and then some who are very loose and a little more free.
Many people are not familiar with paganism and their practices, so there are a lot of misconceptions about the community.
We'll get a lot of questions about, hey, do y'all worship Satan, or do you sacrifice animals?
Yeah, I was identified also as witches.
That we're Satan worshippers and we're not?
Devil worshippers and we're not something like a blight upon the world.
We're not dangerous. We're not evil.
That's probably one of the biggest misconceptions. America is not a one spirituality country.
You are free to do things just because it's the right thing, not because someone up in the sky is saying do it.
You don't have to go to a certain place at a certain time in order to practice paganism. You can do it all day, every day.
For each person, they can pick and choose. It just depends on what they want to follow and what they want themselves to become, to be a better person.
Athens is the perfect place to hold such festivals because of its diverse and tolerant nature.
Athens is a place where you can be whatever you are, whoever you are.
It is definitely a diverse area. The university itself brings in a lot of people from a lot of different places, a lot of different ideologies. And I think because there is such a mishmash, it's very tolerant here.
Understand one thing, it isn't our purpose to convert. We do try to look out, reach out to people who are practicing paganism and not aware.
People who become pagans, very, very few of them are born into a pagan family. Most of them go way out of their way to become pagan, and often by themselves, and they have no community at all. So the side reasons of this is to let the other pagans in the community know that we're here.
You'd walk your path. It can be very different than someone else's. And if you change your mind over time, that's perfectly fine. Recognizing that you are a part of your environment, you're just one part of the whole. You're going to be interacting with everything. Everything you do, everywhere you go, you're going to be interacting with other people, other things, other energies.
The earth is sacred and that we are all part of the earth.
The point of Pagan Pride is very much one of visibility. Go, hey, look, we are your neighbors, we're your friends, we're your coworkers, we're people in your area, your community.
Every person deserves a community, and why should that be any different for pagans?
it makes the community more aware of the pagans in the community.
And it also gives a place for people to come and see what's around and network with different people.
With paganism, I think the beautiful thing about it is that you can express yourself and connect with the sacred in whatever way is meaningful to you. The main tenet and the only thing you really have to live by to be a pagan is do as you will as long as it harms no other. So basically that just means practice how you want and let everybody else do the same.
I didn't even know that festival existed.
Neither did I. The festival was held on College Avenue, which is home to Bubble Cafe, the only cafe in Athens which specializes in bubble tea. Haviva Saltz and I went to find out more about it.
Bubble Cafe is a family-owned business that has been a staple in the downtown cafe scene since 2016. So, what is bubble tea?
It is any kind of tea with boba or any kind of what we call topping into it. And boba is the tapioca. It's this little chewy bubble, and it's made out of plant root. So we have different types of that. We have like flavored versions of it and also kind of jellies and everything that go into the tea. And that pretty much makes everything here a bubble tea. It's all about the actual tea base with a topping in it.
I never knew tapioca was good. Like, it just sounds nasty, but it's good. It surprises me. They always like make it just how I want it.
And sometimes people want anything from like a traditional like herbal tea to anything super sweet. You know, you want extra sugar, you want extra topping in it. We do everything. Pretty customizable. It's probably 90% college students. We have a lot of regulars, but we don't have like a certain type of person other than kind of generally the younger age group, because they like to try new things, and boba tea especially is new in the area.
And I'd never heard of it. And it was amazing.
We're like definitely the only boba focused bubble tea place in Athens, so it kind of makes us stand out a little bit. We've got our little monopoly.
I usually order a blueberry milk slush with boba in it.
Jasmine's my go-to. It's kind of like an herbal sweet, and it's neutral. It's not super one way or the other.
Even though they specialize in bubble tea, Bubble Cafe has a food menu containing over 26 items.
Our food options here are a lot more than what other bubble tea places will do.
The aesthetic is really nice. They're very clean.
It's a lot of fun just kind of being here. It's a very cozy place. Come check things out. We have like any flavor of tea that you are interested in, we have it. We have like a bunch of food here too.
Bubble Cafe is wonderful.
Bubble Cafe is located at 145 College Avenue, and regular teas are around $4.
What's your favorite kind of bubble tea?
I've actually never had it before.
Really? You should travel downtown to get some.
Now let's go to sports news.
This past week at the Clark Oconee Area Meet at Athens Academy, the boys' cross-country team placed 5 out of 7 and the girls' team placed last. They are now preparing for their region meet this week at Helen, Georgia.
The ACAD meet was probably one of the harder meets that I did this season. We had to do a loop twice, and there was this huge hill that made my time, you know, decrease.
Oh, the ACAD meet was harder. It was uphill the whole way. It was pretty tough.
It wasn't my best time. I do plan on improving my time this regional meet. I want to break 20s and get either a mid 1930s maybe.
My time at ACAD was 2011, so I plan to improve on that.
My time was 20 minutes, and yeah, I hope to improve because it's not a good time that I personally like for myself. I personally did worse than I did in my other meets, but I still ran pretty decent because it was one of the hardest courses we ran.
My goal is to break 20s and get 1930 or something like that.
My goal is to break 20 minutes on a regional meet.
I hope to beat 19 minutes and get scrape low 18s, like 1850s around there.
How do you plan on doing that?
Just working hard at practice, I guess, and giving it all in my meet.
Our team's a pretty young team. in past years. We've been training super hard for this regional meet, and I think it would be fine in terms of varsity.
I feel like we're prepared. We ran this course before. Maybe not physically ready, you know? I don't know. We're a slower team compared to the rest, but we should be ready.
Yes, I believe we're very prepared, and we're going to do great at the meet, and we might get state.
The boys varsity football is playing this Thursday against Loganville at home. Make sure to show up. For WJAG-TV, this has been Bram Johnson.
It's been a day for me. Yeah. Hey, I remember syrup sandwiches and crime allowances. Finessing on them with some counterfeits, but now I'm counting this. Parmesan where my accountant lives, in fact, I'm down in this. You say with my boo, babe, tastes like Kool-Aid for the analyst. Girl, I can buy your Westie world with my base stuff. I know that it's good, won't you sit it on my taste buds? I get way too petty once you let me do the extras. Pull up on your block and break it down, we playing Tetris. AM to the PM, PM to the AM phone. Eat up your per diem, you just gotta hate them funk. If I quit your BM, I still rock Mercedes funk. If I quit this season, I still be the greatest funk. My left stroke just went viral. Right stroke put a baby in a spiral. Soprano C, we like to keep it on the high note. It's levels to it, you and I know. Tell them be humble,
holla,
sit
holla,
down,
holla, little, holla,
be humble,
holla,
sit
holla,
down,
sit down, little, sit down,
be humble,
holla, holla,
sit
holla,
down,
holla, little, holla, little,
be humble,
holla.
Thanks, guys.
Jackson Camp is a student involved in marching band, but he also participated in drum corps. Let's go to Joseph Becker with the story.
Jackson Camp was involved with the Spirit of Atlanta Drum Corps based out of Atlanta.
This summer I was a member of the Spirit of Atlanta Drum and Bugle Corps, which went around the country and just toured putting on a bunch of shows. I felt like I was doing pretty good in high school marching band and just high school band in general. I'm like, hey, because I went on the internet and I saw videos of this, and I'm like, hey, that looks pretty cool. So I said, why not go give it a shot? Because there's one an hour and a half away from where I live at. I started playing the trumpet back in sixth grade. About around eighth grade, I kind of said, you know what, this is fun. I really want to keep doing this. So I just started to keep doing it through high school. It gave me something to do. I was the first person from Clark County to make the drum corps out of the entire district.
Unlike regular marching band, the drum corps is very rigorous and work intensive. While in the Spirit of Atlanta, Jackson traveled to many different states to tour and also performed in the Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta.
Yeah, I'm very passionate about music, band, everything itself.
Why is that?
Both my parents are music teachers, and I've just kind of been around it my whole life. Because my dad, he used to be the band director at Cedar from 97 to 2007, and I just kind of got exposed to it at a young age. I hope to do drum corps again, and the first auditions are in November.
Oh my God, that is super awesome!
One last thing before we leave. There will be a blood drive at Cedar on October 30th from 8:30 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. You must be 16 years or older to donate. Please see Ms. Zemfer in room A113 if you're interested for more information. Otherwise, that's all for today.
I'm Aaliyah Nowell.
And I'm Olivia Duber.
And this has been WJAG-TV with your weekly school news. Yeah, and that.
Did we click it, actually?